track inventory stock in and stock out automatically on your inventory list in Excel. To automate stock tracking, we're going to build on the basic inventory list that we created in another video. We're going to create a stock transactions tracker that ties back to your master inventory list. Then we're also going to include a variance tracker so that you can take a physical count of your inventory so you'll have a better, more comprehensive inventory management system in Excel. If you want to get a jump start, you can purchase this template. I'll include a link in the description below, or you can visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. I hope you like this video. Let's get started. Here we have our master inventory list that we created in our other video, which was called Create and Track a Basic Inventory List in Excel. And what we're going to do is we're going to focus on this quantity in stock column. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight this a different color. And what we're going to do, instead of having a static amount that we update here in this column, we're going to create a stock tracker sheet on our workbook that's going to track the stock in and stock out transactions, and we'll dynamically update this column automatically. Let's go down. I'm going to shorten the name of my tab down here. I'm going to double click and rename this Master Inventory. And I want to shorten this so that it'll be easier to reference in formulas. Now let's go ahead and create our new sheet. I'm going to click the plus button, and we're going to create a sheet called Stock Tracker. Now, to save time for this video, I'm going to go ahead and pre-populate this tab, and then I'll walk you through all of the headers. Okay, I have some sample data here, but I want to walk you through what you're going to want to put on your stock tracker tab. We want to have a column for transaction ID, and then we want to have the inventory ID. This is going to exactly match the inventory ID that we have on our master inventory list. We're going to have a transaction date and then a transaction type. This column will be where we track stock in or stock out. Then we're going to have the quantity and a notes column. So once you have this populated with some data, I'm going to go ahead and click anywhere in that table and hit Control T as a shortcut. This is going to select the entire range of data and turn this into a table. So I'm going to click OK. And the reason we want to have this formatted as a table is so that when we add new rows here, it will automatically be included in the table. Now, one thing we want to do is control what goes into the transaction type field. We want it to either be stock in or stock out. So to do that, we're going to create a drop-down list selection. And to do that in Excel, we create what's called a data validation. Now, on this particular workbook, this template already has a tab that's hidden that has another drop-down list that we create on the master inventory list for a yes/no dropdown. So I'm going to come down to any of my tabs. I'm going to right click and select unhide. I can see that data validation list tab that I had hidden. I'm going to select it and click OK. Now that unhides this tab where I had my yes/no dropdown selection. Now I'm going to click anywhere. I can input this anywhere on this sheet that I want, but I'm going to type stock in and stock out for that dropdown list selection. Now I'm going to come back to my stock tracker tab, select the first cell under transaction type, come up to my data tab, and in the data tools area, drop down your data validation. We're going to go ahead and click on the settings tab. Under allow, drop down and select list. Then for your source, put your cursor there, navigate back to your data validation list tab and select your stock in and stock out. And then if you want to put an input message or error alert, you can. And then when you're done, just click OK. So now you have a drop-down list selection for stock in and stock out, and you can hit Control C to copy that and paste it all the way down in your table. Now that we have our table set up with our stock in and stock out transactions, let's set up a pivot table. We're going to click anywhere inside of the table, go up to Insert, drop down Pivot Table, and select From Table or Range. It'll automatically select your table for you. We can put this in the existing workbook, and then in the location, just select a cell where we want to place it, and then click OK. Now over in the pivot table fields area, let's click on the inventory transaction date and drag that down to rows. Let's drag inventory ID down under rows as well. Then we're going to take the transaction type, drag that to columns, and then we're going to take the quantity and drag that under values, and that's going to put the sum of the quantity. Now, while our pivot table is selected, let's come up to the design tab. We're going to turn off the subtotals, go to subtotals, drop down and say do not show subtotals. And same thing with grand totals, drop down and say off for rows and columns. And under report layout, drop down and click on show in tabular form. That's going to put the inventory ID on another column for us. It makes it easier to visualize. Now I'm going to close out of the pivot table fields area, and I'm going to go back to the pivot table analyze tab, and I'm going to insert a slicer. This slicer is going to be for the inventory ID. We're going to check that box and click OK. Now this is a filter that will let us select any of our inventory ID items if we want to look at one item at a time. So for item number one, we can select that. If we want to look at multiple items, we can hit Control and select multiple items. When we want to clear that filter and see everything, all we have to do is hit Clear Filter. Now we can also add a timeline. Select anywhere inside your pivot table, go back up to Pivot Table Analyze, and then go ahead and click on Insert Timeline. We're going to select the transaction date and click OK. We can drag this over, and now we can select on any period of time that we want to look at our data. So if we want to just see for the month of August, we can select that. We can drag and select different date ranges. You can even drop down and select days, quarters, or years after you have more stock transaction data to take a look at. Now that we have our pivot table set up, let's go back to our master inventory list and let's see how we can set up the quantity in stock to dynamically update based on all of the stock in and stock out transactions that we record on the StockTracker tab. So I'm going to go ahead and delete all of these numbers in my column. They were just static numbers that we created for data to have on our inventory list. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a formula in this cell. I'm going to paste the formula in. I'll include it in the description below, and we'll take a look at what this formula is doing. This formula is using SUMIF, and what it's doing is it's taking the inventory ID number from cell A4, and it's looking for that inventory ID number over on the stock tracker, and then it's also looking for anything that says stock in related to that inventory ID number. It's going to add or sum up all of those stock in transactions, and then what it's going to do is it's going to subtract all of the stock out transactions for that same inventory ID number. So you'll have a cumulative stock in and a cumulative stock out that get subtracted to give you your actual quantity in stock. So I'm going to go ahead and navigate to the end of this formula and hit enter. And my chart automatically flash fills that formula all the way down. If yours did not flash fill, all you have to do is copy that formula and paste it down so that the whole column will have that information. Now let's take a look at inventory item number one. We have a quantity in stock of 17. So let's go back to our stock tracker tab and take a look. Let's go over to our slicer and select inventory ID number one. Notice we have an initial stock in of 10, subtract 8 gives us 2, and then add back 15 will give us 17. So back on our master inventory list, that value is 17. So on our stock tracker, let's say that we have some stock out on that item. We're going to go ahead, we're going to select our last row, drag it down, so we'll automatically update a new transaction ID number for us, and we're going to say inventory item number one, and we're going to put today's date, and a shortcut for today's date in Excel is to hit Control semicolon, and then we're going to call this stock out, and we're going to put 3, and we're going to put sold to customer. Now let's go back to our master inventory, and we can now see that our quantity in stock for that item is 14. And if we want to go ahead on the stock tracker tab, scroll back up to our table for our pivot table, we're going to go to pivot table analyze and click on refresh, and that will automatically refresh the pivot table with all of the information, new information that you've added on your stock tracker. Now that we have our stock tracker tab that will automatically update the master inventory list with all of our stock in and stock out transactions, let's go ahead and create a tab for a variance tracker so that we can do a physical inventory count and check for any discrepancies. I'm going to go ahead and click plus to add a new tab, and we'll call this variance tracker. To save time, I'm going to go ahead and automatically populate my headers, and we'll come back and fill this in. Now on the variance tracking tab, let's go ahead and copy down all of our inventory items from our master inventory list. So starting with item number 1 all the way through item 20, I'm going to copy those over to the variance tracker. Now for date, let's say that we do our physical inventory count today. So I'm going to put my shortcut for today's date. We're going to hit Control semicolon and hit enter. I'm going to hit Control C to copy that date, and we're going to copy that all the way down. Now under expected quantity, this is where we want this value to equal whatever the quantity in stock is on the master inventory tab. So we're going to type equals, navigate to master inventory, select our quantity in stock for item number 1 and hit enter. Then we're going to select that cell and double click to copy that formula down. So now our expected quantity will always equal what is the actual quantity in stock on the master inventory list. Now for the variance formula, we're going to type equals, and then we're going to take the actual quantity minus the expected quantity and hit enter. Then we're going to also select that cell and double click on the bottom right corner to copy that down. Now we want to turn this into a table. We'll select anywhere inside of our data and hit Control T and then click OK. This will turn our data into a table. Now I'm going to go ahead and put another header at the top here. I'm going to merge and center my cells. And I'm going to call it Physical Inventory Audit Count. Now I'm going to format this just a little bit. We'll make it a little bigger. We'll increase the font size, make it bold. We can center align it and make it a different fill color. Now I can go and actually take a physical count of my inventory. So I'm going to put that value in the actual count. So let's just say that I only saw 13 of this first item. I did see 45 of the second, and let's say I saw 55 of the next item. Notice that our variance tracker will automatically show us what's happening for the variance. So if we're missing an item, it'll show up as a negative number, and we can put a note that this item might be missing and we might need to go research that. If it's just an inventory check, then it should be a 0. And if we have extra items, it might be a returned item. Now you'll have a way to track your physical inventory and notice if there are any discrepancies that you need to research. Now that we have our stock tracker and variance tracker on our Excel master inventory list, the next thing we want to do is start to analyze our data for trends or patterns that we see on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. So be sure and check out my next video. You'll see how to analyze your data and create dashboards so you can start to see those trends. Be sure and share this video with your friends. You can give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. You can visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com, for more resources. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.